In this Trezor One Setup tutorial, I'm going to show you how to physically set up your device step by step, while also showing all the possible benefits and security features. Then I will show you how to set up your Trezor Suite app the correct way, and then connecting it to MetaMask to make transactions. So make sure to stick with me till the end for that. Now the next step is to set up your Trezor One device. And you're going to need three things: your Trezor, your recovery phrase sheet, and your micro USB cable. So we're going to plug in our USB cable to the computer and then the micro USB side to our Trezor One device. Now go to trezor.io/start and you'll need to download their desktop app. Depending on whether you have the Windows or Mac computer, you'll choose that one, click on Get Desktop App, and then proceed to install the Trezor Suite app on your computer. And now we can move on to setting up our Trezor One device. Click on Setup Trezor, click Continue, and there's two options: Create New Wallet and Recover Wallet. I'm going to show you both of these, but I'm going to start off with Create New Wallet. If you know you need to go with the second option, then skip this step and go to the next part on the timestamp. Now click on Create New Wallet, click on Standard Seed Backup, and now you need to press Confirm on the Trezor device. And now click Create Backup. Select all three of these to make sure that you've read and understand them, and then begin backup. Now this is where the seed phrase recovery sheet comes in handy. You're going to need to write down all the words in your sheet and keep it somewhere very safe and secured where no one can get access to it. One thing that is safe and secure and that you can share very quickly is that like button on this video. So make sure you give that a quick tap. So now I'm going to write down each word one by one. As you can see here, the first word is pon. And then I'm going to fill out the rest of the sheet with all 24 words. Now, while I'm writing down all these recovery phrases, I hope you don't get any ideas and access my wallet with these phrases, expecting there to be some funds in there. I assure you, there's nothing. I'm only showing you my seed phrase for the purpose of this tutorial. But if you want to try and waste your time, then go ahead, be my guest. After you've written everything down, Trezor is going to ask you to check each word one by one more time, to make sure you've written it down correctly. Very important to check it properly, as you won't have another chance to get this right. And now we can continue and set up our PIN. Set PIN, click Confirm on our Trezor, and in this case, I'm just gonna keep it simple and choose 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can see Trezor is very smart, as the number pad is always different every time. So I'll press 1, 2, 3, 4 for the first time, then click Enter PIN, and for the second time, the numbers are at a different spot. 2, 3, 4, and click Enter PIN. And now click on Continue, choose the coins that you want. In this case, I'm happy with just Bitcoin and Ethereum. So I'll click on Complete Setup, click Access Suite, and then I'll just choose the standard wallet for this tutorial. But if you want even a more secure wallet, you can set up the secret wallet there as well. So now we're in our Trezor Suite and we're ready to move on to the next step. So now we're going to go back and set up our Trezor using the recovery phrase in case you have lost or broken your previous hardware device. So first we want to reset our Trezor to the factory settings. And now we're back to where we started. So you can unplug the Trezor, plug it in again. And the same screen will appear for you to set up your Trezor again. And now instead of clicking Create New Wallet, you want to click on Recover Wallet. And in this case, it's going to be 24 words. Click on Standard Recovery, click Confirm. And then the first word is the 21st word, which is clay. And then I would follow the instructions for all 24 words. The next one is 10th word, which is blast. And I'll keep doing this for all of them. And there it is. Recovery is complete, we're in. Click on Continue. Now we'll set our PIN code again, click Confirm, and I'll do 1, 2, 3, 4 again. Re-enter the PIN, click on Continue, choose the coins you want, click on Complete Setup, and access your suite. Click on the standard wallet, and now we're in. So the next step is the Trezor Suite setup. And first of all, if your software or device is out of date, you can come to settings and under application, you would scroll down to suite version and you can check for updates. And if it's not up to date, then you'll be able to download it from here. Or if your Trezor device is out of date, then you would click on device and then check your firmware version here. And if it's not up to date also, then you'll be able to update it here. Another important note on a device section is if you scroll down to the bottom, you can see the auto lock time is preset at 10 minutes, but if for some reason it's not, you should definitely set that up. That's just another little tweak you can do to keep your account safe, and that's just something you should check. The next thing I want to show you is how to add your crypto that you want in case you forgot in the previous step. So you go to crypto and you can add in a coin like Dogecoin. But if you want to add something like XRP or Cardano, then you're going to need the Trezor One Model T, an upgraded version of this Trezor. Let's say we choose Dogecoin, then click on Dogecoin and then go back to your account. And now you should see your Dogecoin here. Now for this next step, I'm going to show you how to send and receive crypto to your Trezor One device. And we're going to start by receiving crypto to our wallet first. So what you would do is click on receive here to retrieve our Bitcoin wallet address. And then we would go to the wallet we want and then click on reveal address. Now on our Trezor device, click on confirm. And now we can copy our address. And for this video tutorial, I'm going to use FTX to send my Bitcoin over. FTX is my exchange of choice at the moment, as I think I have really good rates and are safe to use. So if you want to get some discount on the trading fees and you want to try FTX out, then you can check out my link here or in the description and use that to get started. Anyway, moving on, I'm going to send 0.0002 Bitcoin to my address. And so under BTC address, I'm going to paste in our Trezor wallet address. Now I'm going to put in my 2FA authentication code, 983234. Click on withdraw, and now we can go back to our Trezor Suite app, and we would give it a few minutes for our Bitcoin to arrive. So our existing Bitcoin amount is 0.000198, and now you can see our new amount is 0.00373. So the Bitcoin has arrived, and we can double check this by going to our accounts, and you can see here our Bitcoin was received, minus the withdrawal fees from FTX. And the next step is to send our Bitcoin. So I'm going to click on send. And for the address, I'm sending this back to my FTX account. So I'll click address and paste in my FTX account. And for the amount, I'll just do 0.0001. And now for the fee section, you can choose low, economy, normal, or high. And for different fees, for example, economy, it'll take roughly 4 hours, normal 1 hour, high 10 minutes. Or you can customize what you want. So if you're not in a rush, go economy. But if you are, then go high. So in this case, I'm not in a rush. I just want to show you as an example. So I'm going to use economy. And once you're happy with the address, the amount, and the fee, then you can click review and send. Now from your Trezor device, you'll have to confirm the transaction by clicking confirm twice there. And then back on your Trezor Suite app, you will click on send. And that's it. You can see that our Bitcoin is being sent out from our wallet address. One other thing to note is that if you don't have any Bitcoin or cryptocurrency in your Trezor wallet, but you want to buy some quickly, then Trezor also offer this service by going down to accounts and then click on buy BTC. And this is done through Invity. Of course, exchange rates aren't going to be as good as the top crypto exchanges, but it's still an option there for you. The next thing I want to show you is how to connect your Trezor wallet to your MetaMask account. If you're looking to do any sort of DeFi or NFT related stuff, you'll need to know how to set this up. So from your browser, you'd open your MetaMask account. And by the way, if you haven't got MetaMask set up, I've got a full video in the description that you can check out, which will guide you step by step on how to set up MetaMask. But once it's set up, you click here and then click on connect hardware wallet. And now we'll pick Trezor to continue and now click allow and export. If you want to access our default wallet, you just leave this blank and click on enter. Select your MetaMask wallet, which is the same as your Trezor Suite. So we can go back to our Ethereum wallet and check the wallet address. 1767. So this is the one. Now we click on unlock. And there's our Trezor One wallet connected successfully to MetaMask. And now you can load it up and make transfers. Now I'm going to show you how to send and receive crypto to your Trezor wallet through the MetaMask app. First of all, we want to receive some funds into our wallet address. So we would copy our wallet here and then go to another account. Then click send, paste in our Trezor wallet address, put in the amount you want to transfer, just do 0.1, click next and then confirm. Now we go back to our Trezor wallet address and it should update to 0.1492 in a second. And there it is, our funds have arrived. So we're ready to send crypto out of our Trezor wallet to another address. So now you would go send, paste in the address. In this case, I'm sending it back to the original wallet and the amount will be 0.1 again. Now click next and then click confirm. And now MetaMask will want to interact with your physical Trezor wallet. So then you allow once for this session, hit enter, and then from your Trezor wallet, you want to confirm the amount and the address. And if that's right, then click on confirm, confirm the fee, wait a few seconds again, and the account will deduct the 0.1 that we transferred out. There it is. Now, if you want more information on this Trezor One device, then I recommend you check out this next video here, where I do a full in-depth review on the product. But if you're looking for an alternative hardware wallet, then go to this video where I show you the best hardware wallet you should get. So check it out and I'll see you over the next tutorial.